Since the release of next-gen consoles, there's been a high demand for high-quality TV displays that complement these now current generation consoles. Once you're able to secure one of either the PlayStation 5 or the Xbox Series X, the next thing you'll probably be thinking about is finding a TV powerful enough to match the power of either console. There's certainly lots of things to consider in a TV other than the type of display technology it uses, but as a gamer, you might want to give more consideration to this part of the TV. What's going on, guys? It's Midas here, and in this video, I'll be going over the best features of OLED display technology that make it the perfect high-quality display for gaming on the PS5, Xbox Series X, and other high-performance gaming consoles. Before we dive right into this video, I'd like to give a shout out to LG Display for sponsoring this video. Most TVs you'll see around are labeled LED, which means they use LCD displays. TVs with this type of display are more commonly used due to how inexpensive they are and the fact that they come in multiple sizes. LG Display's OLED technology is newer in comparison to LCDs. TVs with OLED displays aren't as common as those with LCDs due to how expensive they are and the fact that they come with fewer size configurations. If you're looking for the perfect display type for gaming with your PS5 or Xbox Series X, look no further than LG Display's OLED. LG Display is the sole manufacturer of OLED display technology right now, but I'm sure you've noticed some other brands making OLED TVs. These brands all get their OLED displays from LG Display. In this video, I'll be pairing a TV with an LG OLED display with the PS5 to test certain games that help showcase the best features of an OLED display when it comes to gaming. I'll also be testing a TV with an LCD display as a basis of comparison to showcase the superiority of an OLED display for gaming purposes. These OLED display features might give you justification as to why you should consider getting an OLED TV. Okay, the first thing I'll let you know is that OLED stands for Organic Light Emitting Diode, and the display is made up of individual image elements called pixels, composed of organic chemical compounds, which emit light when an electric current is applied between the anode and cathode of each pixel. That probably sounds like a bunch of mumbo jumbo to some of you, but don't worry, we'll talk about it more. OLEDs are displays that do not require a backlight and so are thinner and more efficient than LCD displays, which do require a white backlight. Unlike the common LCD displays you tend to see around, OLED displays are self-emissive, as every pixel emits light and color individually, controlling themselves in a process called pixel dimming. Thanks to pixel dimming, OLED displays can realize brighter or darker images with extreme accuracy, resulting in superior picture quality. This is also why OLED can offer perfect blacks, which is considered the base for all other colors and can therefore provide realistic and natural picture quality without any distortions. OLED displays feature two extremely important attributes that I'm sure most gamers will appreciate. The first is low response times or fast response times, and the second is low input lag. Some of you might not understand what those attributes mean yet, or might just confuse them. Let's talk about them as well as some of the other amazing features of LG's OLED display that make it the perfect fit for gaming on evolving consoles. First, let's talk about the low response time of OLED display technology. Response time is the amount of time it takes a pixel to change from one color to the next. Think of response time like this. Assuming you're playing a first-person shooter game like Call of Duty and decide to turn left into a tunnel, your TV gets the information from your console and needs to update the image you see to reflect the new graphics being loaded in. Lower or faster response times are always better because they cut down on image issues like blurring or ghosting, and this is extremely important for gamers, especially when playing first-person shooter games like Call of Duty or Battlefield, where you have to aim all over and the screen changes quite often and quickly. For a sense of comparison, LCD displays go through a lot more layers, leading to delays in response time, which isn't all that great for gaming. They typically adjust the amount of light through backlight, color filters, and liquid crystal molecules to create images. These layers ultimately lead to slow response times. In contrast, OLED is self-emitting and lacks the extra layers that LCD does, and this allows it to create faster images for faster, smoother gameplay. OLED currently offers the fastest response time of any TV technology in use today. In comparison to the conventional LCD display, which offers about 11 milliseconds in response time, OLED displays offer about 0.1 milliseconds, which means the OLED display color can change 100 times within the same 1 second that an LCD display color can change only once. OLED is that display that can best express game content that has fast dynamic movements with the most accuracy. I'm talking about first-person shooter games like Call of Duty and Battlefield, as well as sports games like NBA 2K21 and car racing games like Rocket League. The next gaming advantage that OLED TVs offer is a low input lag. Input lag is the amount of time it takes from the moment a video signal enters the TV, say from the HDMI, to the final screen change. Basically, the input lag determines the speed at which the screen changes. The shorter the time, the better, obviously. The word input mostly refers to the user. An individual presses a key or clicks a button on the keyboard or controller and expects a corresponding action on the screen. The time needed to show you that action refers to the input lag. When you change the content on a TV screen, the TV does not send and receive all signals at once. Instead, it receives signals line by line. Let's say a TV is set to 60 Hz refresh rate. It takes that TV 1 over 60 seconds to update the image on the screen from the top to the bottom, as opposed to being shown at once. The same goes for 120 Hz refresh rate. The input lag time is even lower since it now takes only 1 over 120 seconds for the signal to display from top to bottom. When the input lag of LCD and OLED displays are compared using the testing device and both TVs with either display are set to the same refresh rate for accuracy, say 60 Hz, you'll find that OLEDs have a lower input lag. During two input lag tests conducted between both display types, the LCD had a 14.7 millisecond input lag when the response time of the display wasn't taken into consideration, while the OLED had a 9.5 millisecond input lag, so the OLED beats the LCD in this case. When response time was added to the mix, the LCD had a 21.7 millisecond input lag, while the OLED had a 9.8 millisecond input lag, and both TVs used were set to 60 Hz refresh rate throughout the tests. From the results, this clearly indicates that OLED is the better display when it comes to input lag. Response time affects the input lag of any display technology. If the display technology has a slower response time, much like LCDs, the input lag will be slow as well. In contrast, if the display technology has a faster response time like OLEDs, the input lag will in turn be unaffected or faster. Let's talk about how refresh rate and input lag are connected. A lot of people do this, but do not confuse response time and input lag with refresh rate. Refresh rate is how many times per second a screen or display can draw a new image. The higher the refresh rate, the smoother the screen moves. The refresh rate of a TV does not depend on the type of display it uses, so consider this value based on the TV and not whether it's OLED or LCD. The same OLED display panels can be used on two TVs with different maximum refresh rates. For example, a TV with a maximum of 60 Hz refresh rate can have the same OLED display panel as a TV with a maximum of 120 Hz refresh rate. Therefore, the refresh rate of a TV does not depend on whether it uses an LCD or an OLED display. The refresh rate of a TV does affect the input lag value of the display. The higher the refresh rate, the lower the input lag. So basically, the refresh rate and the response time affects the input lag. The higher the refresh rate, the faster response time, the lower the input lag. In the case of OLED displays, there's already a low input lag, and so a TV with an OLED display and a high refresh rate would be the ideal choice for you if you're going to be gaming a lot. You want to opt for a TV that has a maximum refresh rate at its highest resolution. For example, a TV that features up to 120 Hz refresh rate at 4K resolution. These kinds of TVs require at least one HDMI 2.1 input to access anything beyond 4K at 60 Hz refresh rate, so take note of that. The PS5 and Xbox Series X both allow you to play games at up to 120 frames per second at 4K resolution. If you don't have a TV that allows up to 120 Hz refresh rates at 4K resolution using an HDMI 2.1 connection, then you'll only be able to play at up to 60 frames per second at 4K resolution or 120 frames per second, but at a downscaled resolution of 1080. The next feature of OLED displays to highlight for better gameplay is the perfect blacks. The pure black with self-lighting pixels of OLED produces infinite contrast and perfect black without light leakage. This might not make much sense to you, but basically, perfect blacks in turn produce visually pleasing images and accurate colors. If your gaming setup is in a dark room or you just happen to game often at nighttime, then OLED is a fantastic choice for that purpose. By turning off its pixels completely and producing perfect blacks, it delivers stunning picture quality in those dark lighting conditions. If you set your TV to standard or game mode, the OLED TV is going to express black mode and color gradation perfectly, so it's going to accurately provide colors. So make sure you have your TV in one of these modes while gaming. Local dimming doesn't work very well with the LCD's game mode since it does not provide any mini LED effect. So the black mode is not as intense as say on the OLED. And color reproduction is not as pristine. Unlike LCDs, OLED can provide perfect black levels and lower input lags at the same time. So LCD TVs cannot do that. So when you switch game mode on an LCD TV, it just turns on local dimming. With LCD's local dimming, while it can make deeper blacks, it could also increase your input lag levels. If you do decide to turn off local dimming or game mode on the LCD TV, you're going to reduce input lag, but the black level goes bad again. So you can't have both while working with an LCD TV display, but when working with an OLED TV display, you can get both good black levels and good input lags while playing under game mode or standard mode. Another OLED display feature that I found to be great for gaming is the accurate color reproduction for both bright and dark images. I found that every color appears as they should, even in some overly bright and dark parts during gameplay. OLED features 100% pixel dimming and 100% color fidelity, and this leads to a high color accuracy. Now, I don't know about you, but when I game, it's for long sessions most of the time. As far as eye comfort is concerned, OLED TVs are flicker-free and feature low blue light, as well as less glare to boost eye comfort after long exposure. OLED TVs also offer superb viewing angles. You might not always play off-center, but when you do find yourself in that scenario, everything still looks pristine with OLED TVs from any angle. Far right, left, top, and bottom. Another feature worth mentioning as regards gaming is the Cinematic Sound OLED Panel, CSOP for short. This isn't available on every single OLED display. LG Display was the first in the world to develop and produce Cinematic Sound OLED, a panel which uses large OLED modules to vibrate the TV panel and play sound, so users can hear the sound directly from the screen for a theater-like experience. This is a feature that I think a lot of gamers would appreciate. I personally believe OLED display technology was made with gamers in mind. The technology features an insanely fast response time and very low input lag for effective synchronization between input and output signals. Response time and input lag are extremely important values to watch for when shopping for a gaming TV. Some of the best features of OLED displays include better image quality, which means blacker blacks and brighter whites, reduced power consumption, and much faster response time. And that last point is what makes OLED displays worth considering if you're on the search for a solid gaming TV. Although, OLEDs have a few cons too, like they're expensive to produce, and so that means that they're also expensive for buyers to purchase. But they've definitely been getting a lot cheaper as time goes on. They also tend to come in fewer sizes, but that's also changing as well. The lifespan of an OLED display is about 8 to 11 years of constant use, and I think that's a lot. OLEDs also might not prevail in overly bright rooms where the sun hits the screen directly, hence why they're perfect for gaming since most people tend to game in dark settings. The combination of perfect blacks, low response time, low input lag, accurate color reproduction, and other gaming features of OLED displays make them undeniably the best to match with the PS5 and other next generation consoles, especially when compared to the conventional LCD display. Remember that even with the same display technology, the gaming performance of any TV depends on how the final product turns out. To find out more information about OLED displays, make sure to check the link down in the description below. I hope you guys have found this video useful in making your decision on what kind of TV display to get for your console. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button below, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and turn on notifications to be notified when I post new videos. Thanks for watching. It's Midas, and I'm out.